In this video, we will learn the application of fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Let us take an example. Find the LCM and HCF of 12, 15 and 21 by prime factorization method. So, let us find the factors of 12, 15 and 21 in the working column. So, the factors of 12 are, on dividing 12 by 2, we get 6. Again, on dividing 6 by 2, we get 3. 3 is a prime number. On dividing 3 by 3, we get 1. Therefore, the factors of 12 are 2 times, 3 and 1. Don't forget this one. Now, let us find the factors of 15. 15 is not divisible by 2. Therefore, take the next prime number, 3. On dividing 15 by 3, we get 5. Now, 5 is a prime number. So, divide 5 by 5, we get 1. Thus, the factors of 15 are 3, 5 and 1. Now, let us find the factors of 21. 21 cannot be divided by 2. If we take the next prime number 3, it can be divided. Therefore, on dividing 21 by 3, we get 7. On dividing 7 by 7, we get 1. Thus, the factors of 21 are 3, 7 and 1. Now, let us write the factors in the solution part. Therefore, the factors of 12 are 1 into 2 square into 3. The factors of 15 are 1 into 3 into 5. And the factors of 21 are 1 into 3 into 7. All the factors are written in ascending order. Now, observe the factors and make a list of the factors which are present in all the threes. So, here is a list of the factors. The factors are 1, 2, 3, 5 and 7. Now, let us find LCM. So, the LCM is equal to, for the LCM, select the factors which are present maximum times. Let us think of 1. So, 1 is present 1 time in 12, 1 time in 15 and 1 time in 21. Therefore, the maximum presence of 1 is 1 times. So, we will write 1 in the LCM part. Now, let us think of the second factor, 2. 2 is present 2 times in 12, it is absent in 15 and absent in 21 also. Thus, the maximum presence of 2 is 2 times in 12. Therefore, we select 2 times 2 and write it in the LCM part. Now, let us think of the next prime factor, 3. Now, 3 is present 1 times in 12, 1 times in 15 and 1 times in 21. Thus, the maximum presence of 3 is 1 time. Therefore, write 3 in the LCM part. Then, the next factor is 5. Now, 5 is present 1 time in 15, whereas it is absent in 12 as well as in 21. Therefore, write 5 1 time, which is a maximum presence. Now, take the last factor 7. Now, 7 is present 1 times in 21, it is absent in 12 and 15. Therefore, the maximum presence of 7 is 1 times. So, write 7 in the LCM part. Now, on multiplying the factors, we get 420 as the multiplication answer. Therefore, the LCM is 420. Now, let us find the HCF. For HCF, we select the factors which are present minimum times. So, let us take 1. Now, 1 is present 1 times in all the 3 factors. Therefore, the minimum presence is also 1. Now, think of the second factor, 2. Now, 2 is present 2 times in 12, whereas it is absent in 15 and 21. Therefore, it will be absent in HCF part. Now, think of the next factor, 3. 3 is present 1 time in all the 3 numbers. Therefore, the minimum presence is 1 times. Therefore, take 3 in HCF part. Now, the next factor is 5. 5 is present 1 times in 15 and it is absent in 12 and 21. Therefore, it will be absent in HCF part. Now, take the last factor 7. It is present 1 times in 21 and it is absent in 12 and 15. Therefore, it will be absent in HCF part also. Thus, on multiplying the HCF factors, we get 3. That is 1 into 3 is 3. Thus, we can write the answer. LCM equals 420 and HCF equals 3. Thus, we finish the problem.